Today we're going to be fishing Lake Worth, Snook Island. It's a project they started about, it's been about 7 years ago. Made a bunch of islands and made it habitat for snook. And we're going to go out there, we're going to give it a shot. A little windy for offshore and getting a little cloudy right now, but hopefully the snook will be biting. Snook Island project, man, it's quite something. You got to check that out. There it is there, man. We're going to go out there and we're going to see what we can hammer some nice snook. There we go. Pulling up, meeting my buddy Joe. His buddy John, man. These guys I've fished with quite a few times. Joe is definitely bad luck. If there's any fish around, then he definitely scares them off. But maybe today he'll bring us some luck. Snook Island Project, this is a new dock, they just put this in. Spent several $1 million on this whole project, but well worth it.
So this is the one, the Wind Cheater is the one he said?
Wind Cheater is a great one, yeah.
This one?
Yeah, that'll do it.
So actually, what should I tie on to my big rod?
Wind Cheater. Yeah, we're out here at Snook Island. Fishing this until the sun goes down, and then once the sun goes down we're going to fish the Lake Avenue Bridge, and that's where we're hopefully really running some big snook. Right now it's been kind of slow, a few fish popping around, but not much else happening, but I'm going to give it a try. This area can be very productive at times. It can hold some nice snook, and I've got some nice flounder here, a few reports of a red every once in a blue moon, and a few trout, but it's mostly a snook spot. We're going to give it a try, we're going to see what we can come up with, and so far, been a little slow, but the action is going to start tonight. I got my camera set up with a little bit of a night light. I'm not sure how it's going to come out. Hopefully they're going to come out clear, because I have a feeling we're going to have some good rods. Anyway, got to start fishing some more. Okay, it's just starting to get dark. Pulling a plug. We're hooked up. There we go. Fish on. That's what I'm talking about. Just starting to get dark, man. Just start trolling that shadow line. Oh yeah! It's just snook. There we go. Nice one. Snook! Trolling a plug in the shadow line, man.
What?
Snook! Here we go.
Okay.
Ooh, that's a nice one. There we go, Mr. Snook. I don't know, I'll take some. 1 minute, I'll go get a measurement on him. Everything here.
You got him in there? He's still on your
Yeah, he's still on my lip grip. Gotta get a big. Well, you got a flash on there?
Yeah.
I have one with a flash here. Okay, Joe's got his snook. Get a little better light here. Oh, dandy there. Go. Gotta hold him up, Joe. Blind you for a minute. All right, there we go. Okay, let's get a measurement on him. Get him back in the water. Oh, whoa! Another one, man. Ah, smaller one. Whoa! Woo! Bring him over here. Woo! be alright. This is a small one here.
Okay, you want a picture?
That's alright. Okay. Whoa! Woo! This thing's going crazy, man. Nighttime, man, they're turning on. Small one, but a nice one. Get them back in the water. These pliers.
The damn thing in my pants.
All right, Joe. Catch of the day right there, buddy. There we go. This is what we're after here. Mr. Snook. It's a Lake Worth snook here, right here. There, Joe, get you good blind, night blinded. That's what it's all about, man. That's what we're doing here. Controlling these plugs in the shadow lines. Yeah, it don't take long. We got a measurement on them now.
Now we're heading in. Not a bad night. Now we're fishing low tide. Lake Avenue Bridge. Tide just stopped. So did the fishing. So, yeah, we're heading in. Got two keeper size. So we got dinner for tonight. We're going to have to do this again. Next time, I'm going to try high tide. And here, high tide's better than the low tide. And, anyway, it's still a great day to be on the water. A little different from this offshore, but a lot of fun. Hey, Larry, you ready? Okay, made it back in. Fairly successful. Got two keepers. Joe got one, I got one, and Larry, oh well, next time, Larry.
That's right.
Larry fished hard. Nice looking fish.
We'll get him. We'll get him next time.
Had a great evening, though.
Oh, yeah, it was. All right, let's get these fish cleaned. Where are they? Yeah, there. Well, we had a great trip out there. Caught 10 snook, didn't lose one plug. Fishing the shadow lines, that's off of Lake Worth and Lake Worth Avenue Bridge and Snook Island area. The key to our success, I really think, was the pedal drive kayaks. My buddies were in Hobies. I was in the Mariner 12.5. It's a native kayak. If you're not familiar with this, it's a really, really neat kayak. The pedal drive system is like a bicycle drive with an outboard lower unit. And the one advantage I see over Hobie is that you do have reverse. It's got a 10-to-1 gear ratio. This thing worked really well. It's a new generation. The first generation had a different prop. I wasn't too excited about it, but now with this new prop design, you can tell the new one right here, it's going to have a little area here we can unscrew the prop and change the shear pin if you need to. But this prop really makes a difference in how hard it is to pedal. It is super nice now. I really do enjoy it. It is a lot of fun. Using this drive units, we were able to hook snook, and then we're able to pull them away from the bridge while holding the rod the whole time, which was key, because some of these fish can be really big. And that is a key, getting that fish away from that bridge at night, dealing with the current and dealing with the bridge and the large fish. Talk a little bit more about the camera mount. Got the new Scotty camera mount. Really love this thing. I got it set up here. First time nighttime video, so I had to make some adjustments. Got a night light over here. This will shoot a red light, it'll shoot a high beam and wide beam. And I think I gotta adjust it this time, so the next trip out, I think the lighting will be a lot better. Turn the light on, turn the camera on, ready to go. I can change the angle any way I want to with a Scotty mount. It really makes it nice. So next time, hopefully the video is gonna be a little more clear, a little bit better. But I think you all got the idea. Lights here. Got a little glow stick. These are great. They're only like $3 or so. I sit there, turn it on. I stick it right here in this pocket. It kind of gives a low light, kind of lights up the bottom of the boat. Also, this hooks up the little 12-volt battery. This is designed to actually go in the water. Gives a green light. I stick it underneath the seat, and it basically just lights up the whole bottom of the boat without distorting my night vision. On the head, these headlamps work great. All different types of beams that you can have come off this. From a red to a bright to a wide beam, and always good to have that. The other lighting for nighttime fishing, you gotta have a 360 degree light, and that's what I got here. It's a Scotty's. This thing works great. Always have it on there. Even when I make trips out early in the morning or late in the evening, I like to have, make sure I'm lit up so those power boats can see me. And the key bait here that I was using, Arapala X-Wrap. I was trolling this lure, and I love this boat here because I'm able to hold the rod. I'm able to feel that lure. As that lure hits that bottom, I know I'm right in that area. Those fish are feeding right on the bottom, so I'm skipping this lure and just kind of bouncing it off the rocks in the bottom as we're trolling. If I don't feel it hitting the bottom, I'll drop my rod tip down a little bit lower. Even sometimes put the rod tip in the water column to get that lure down. Worked really well. I was using the Torque International 100. This is my jigging reel, but this really is a great reel for pulling snook and fighting big tarpon around bridges and structure. It has some horsepower to it. 30 pound braid on it, and I was able to get every fish away from that bridge with no problem at all. Great system. I got a Scotty extender. I have it extended out. Most of the time the rod's in my hand, but if I do need to put the rod in to secure a fish, rod goes right in there, and it's ready to go. But it's kind of a quick layout of the boat. If you never tried one of these, definitely worth trying. Really excited about it. It was a great nighttime trip. It did really well. And like I say, I can't wait to get out there again. Shoot a little bit better video, a little bit better lighting, and I'll let you know how we do.